Permit me to welcome and greet to the podium His Excellency the Deputy Governor of Bayelsa State, His Excellency Lawrence L. Jackson, representing the Governor of Bayelsa State, to deliver his goodwill comments.
Your Excellency, the former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Ezekiwe Jonathan, GCON, GCFR, our own, exported to Nigeria and extrapolated to Africa and generalized to the world. Inshallah, who becomes very useful, though is a salt on the community, that does not divorce the parents. And so you are proudly Bayelsa, but again, you are generally Nigerian and omni Africa and the world by virtue of what you have done to strengthen and entrench our democracy. The President of the Senate, my boss before now, and still my boss, Dr. Ahmed Lawa, who was really mentoring me in the Senate before I left, the Secretary to Government of the Federation, the Governors of Bauchi State, my senior brother, the Governors of Kogi State, members of the National Assembly, representatives of governors that are here, the keynote speaker, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, with your due permission, let me sit by the already established protocol so that I do not take much of our time. I wish to, on behalf of His Excellency, the Governor of Bayelsa State, first of all, convey the sentiment of apology to our father, the beacon, the cornerstone of Nigerian democracy, His Excellency Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan. As you are aware, he's on a short leave and has asked me to represent him. And as you all know, the job of a spare tire cannot be the same as the job of the main tire. But the most important thing is that the vehicle will get to destination. And so the vehicle is at destination. And so, he has also asked me to convey the sentiments to all of us who have come together around our father today. A tree does not make a forest. A forest is made of several trees. And so without your presence, the thickness of the man who celebrates highly in Bayelsa cannot be a forest. And so I want to thank all of you who have come together today to be with our father. Tomorrow is his birthday, so in advance, happy birthday in advance. And we believe that God will continue to keep you because you have not finished your assignments. We are looking forward to your many more contributions towards society. I will really be doing a very little goodwill message, but it also be unfair for me to come here and not dwell a little bit on the issues that topic has raised, which is democracy and unity of the state. I do not believe that a good driver should always persistently drive with his rear mirror. Drivers drive four vehicles by virtue of the highway regulation. You drive the vehicle in your front, the one approaching you, the one you are driving, and the one behind you. And so if you focus so much on the one behind you and looking at the rear mirror, what happens is that you may either crash into the one ahead of you, or you crash into the one coming against you, or you actually veer off the road. And so as Africans, can we continue to blame our woes on the colonial masters? That is where I wish to a little bit take a step out of the route the professor and the keynote speaker has followed. I believe that it is sense for us to look inwards. A marriage is successful not at the instance of the Reverend Father who did the wedding. A marriage is successful at the instance of the couple. And so, if even the colonial masters have brought us together, which is what happened in marriage, nobody and his wife are from the same family. Some guys are not even from the same town. They are not from the same tribe. But here they come together and they drop what was binding them in their family and come to be united as a group. I think that is the problem we have in Africa. We have refused to leave our families, where our fathers and mothers are giving directive to see that we are now adults, that are now a husband and wife, which is prescribed by the Bible to have become one. If you continue to remain a houseboy and a bum boy in your father's house, and a baby boy in your mother's house, and a baby in your father's house, when you come into a marriage, the marriage does not last long. And so the wisdom we should take is that, as Nigerians, as Africans, even though the colonial masters have done the mistake of bringing it all together, let us take the philosophy of a marriage, where the husband and wife forget their parents and stick together and remain together. I believe by the time we go in this trajectory, Africa will become more united, Nigeria will become more united. Now, what are some of the ingredients of democracy and unity? A man who goes to the river to fetch water with a basket, with the hope of filling a drum, will not only be deceiving himself, will also assuredly be laboring himself. These tools and the cornerstones we have laid for ourselves sometimes have not supported our unity in democracy. I say this with all sense of humility. Unity will remove the scale of bias from my eyes, even after the baptism, like Paul, and I will see myself as a Nigerian. So I would rather, now that the Mr. President of the Senate is here, that we expunge some of these legal limitations. Let us leave state of origin. Let us see ourselves as Nigerian. The United States, there's no state of origin in the United States. And so the wife of Clinton is from a different state. The daughter of Clinton is from a different state. Clinton himself from a different state. And until we get to this point of cruising altitude, we will continue to deceive ourselves that we are going to be united in democracy. So I will prescribe that we change this state of origin, which is just our place of residence. And so if I have place of residence, and I have stayed in Kogi for up to 10, 15 years, I should be allowed to contest election there. If I have stayed in Bauchi for more than 3 months, 4 months, I should be allowed to contest election there. It's only when we do that we will now destroy this erected wall of division and disparity that we want to break down. I believe that is one way democracy can unite us. We've also had the misfortune of having those we call nationalists, who, in my opinion, have not risen above tribal borders. I would rather recommend that our nationalists must trajectorize at the level of the Kwame Nkrumah, the level of Winston Churchill, the level of Napoleon Bonaparte, the level of other African leaders, so that at the end of the day, we do not deceive ourselves that we have nationalists who actually are just defenders of their territorial, tribal, and judicial or judicial areas. It's on that note, I want to recommend that we should have what we call empathetic leader, not soporific leaders. A good janitor sees the mess committed by the children as a mess and cleans it up. But a bad janitor complains and sees it as a challenge. What we have here is not a challenge. What we have here is a mess. Let all of us get the broom, get the mop, we clean it up, and shall be united. Thank you, and God bless.